Want to level up your food and travel experience? A luxury cruise to the gastronomic hotspot of Vietnam may just be what you're looking for, my foodie friends. As my kids and I are finding out aboard the Superstar Virgo, it is an experience unlike any other.
Hi, I'm Sandy Daza and welcome to FoodPrints Vietnam Special. In our first episode, we did some exploration of Ho Chi Minh City. We did shopping, a little eating also. I had a cooking demo that time. I'm going to do a second cooking demo this time. I'm looking forward to our visit to Nha Trang, another province of Vietnam. I am told we're going to go around in a scooter doing food tour explorations. Is so exciting with my kids pa. Nakakatawa. There's so much activity in this ship. I'm going to explore the whole ship. I'm going to go around. We'll play bingo. There's sing-along. There's bar. There's dancing. Whatever you want to do. There's so much activity here. So, all aboard. Let's go.
We're halfway through our six-day cruise and I'm happy to report that we're all still in high spirits. There seems to be no end to the interesting things you can discover aboard.
We're going to be eating a lot of food, so I'm going to head to the gym to offset and check out the rest of the other facilities.
Let's play basketball.
You?
No, I want a duck. You play basketball with
that? No. Correct. I'm going to hit the pool. Come with me to the gym.
It's a sunny day.
Okay, yeah,
yeah,
nice.
Okay.
Let's explore the whole ship.
See you guys.
Up. See ya.
Okay, bye now.
The Star Cruises fleet promises an amazing range of onboard activities and amenities. And the Superstar Virgo really delivers. Salon, duty-free shopping, game rooms, special shows, you name it, they probably have it. Any father would relish spending time with their kids. But let's be real. 6 days in a confined space with four millennials? I'll take all the me time I can get. But of course, the whole point of going on a cruise is to bond with your loved ones, diba? Especially during mealtime.
Right now, we're here in this Japanese restaurant. As you can tell, the way the napkins are folded, that we're in a fine dining Japanese restaurant in the cruise. Now, this is a dining option. Anyway, we're gonna have a teppanyaki lunch. We're gonna have steaks and I guess fried rice. I look forward to this. Japanese fried rice is the best.
So they're gonna cook it in front of us?
They're gonna cook it in front of us.
There are 10 restaurants on the ship. And your cruise ticket entitles you to free buffet meals at 3 of them. If you want something a little more fancy though, you can put your access card to good use in the other restaurants.
You know, one thing about Japanese cooking, they want you to focus on the main ingredient, which is the beef. So seasoning is very minimal.
Don't be surprised if the chefs in the other restaurants are Pinoy.
So what he did was he sauteed the steak and just browned it a bit, and then put garlic, mix that with garlic, salt, pepper, and then garlic butter, and that's it.
Yeah,
and
simple.
A little soy sauce also. Hikuman, actually.
Will it surprise you to know that Chef Jerry also holds sushi-making classes on board? You can learn how to make these.
You know, one thing I noticed, Jerry, he left some of the flavorings of the steak on the teppanyaki grill. That's what he's going to use to flavor the part of the garlic rice. Diba? That's what you call deglazing. Sarap nitong chawan mushi, ha? It's creamy, di ba?
Yeah.
And it's warm.
I love Philippines!
Babe! Okay to, ah. Ngayon ko lang nakita. Si Jerry has tricks I've never seen before. I've seen a lot before, yung mga Benihana. Bago yun kay Jerry.
This is definitely a step up from the pre-buffet meals on board. I highly recommend this restaurant.
Jerry, sarap. Very masarap. Very, very masarap. Ito parang ano, bean sprout teppan, they call it. Pero parang Japanese chapsuy, eh, di ba? No? Ganun na naman. You know, very minimal lang ang seasoning. So you can focus on the freshness of the vegetables. You can really taste the quality of the beef because it's very minimally seasoned. And then the rice also is not so overpowering yung seasoning niya. So the combination of both, you can really taste the quality of the rice, the simplicity of the Japanese fried rice, and then the beefiness of this tender angus. Sarap! Mm.
Come for the wonderful teppan meal, stay for Jerry's fun showmanship. No wonder this restaurant is the favorite of the captain and his officers.
Alright, thank you, Jerry. Huh?
Jerry.
Laban, very, very good.
When we come back, we explore our second exciting port of call, Nha Trang. There will be food. There will be scooters. And there will also be pasalubong.
Thank you very much, Tao.
Welcome to Pit Stop from Vietnam.
This is so good.
That's up next on FoodPrints. Most exciting part of life on a cruise ship is going to bed in one part of the world and waking up in an entirely different location. Our second port of call in Vietnam is fast approaching and I can't wait to land on its shores.
We just got here in Nha Trang and I'm so excited because I'm going to explore a place I've never been to before and I'm told the street food here is great. We're going to go around in scooters and I'm gonna be with my kids. Come on, boys. Kakain tayo. Kakain tayo na masarap. You know, how interesting because I've never been here before.
Yeah.
I don't know what to expect. Mm-hmm. But I'm sure Vietnam food, di ba? Sarap yun.
Oh, I heard we're gonna ride scooters.
Yes, we will do that. Okay, let's go.
Let's do it.
Star Cruises offers exclusive tours around its ports of call. We availed of one back in Ho Chi Minh. But you can also book a custom local tour like what we're doing this time around. We're on our way downtown with Tao, the organizer of Nha Trang Street Food Tour.
Okay, this is going to be the start of our street food tour in here. And we're going to go around in scooters.
Yep.
Isn't that exciting?
Yep.
How many of you have been in scooters before? You have?
Yeah. Huh? I have.
Are we gonna drive?
No. We're going to make a no. We're just going to ride at the back. We have drivers.
Yeah.
Okay, so safety
Let's
first.
Go, Cass.
I've always enjoyed getting around new destinations on foot. But here, the most thrilling way to start an adventure is to hop on a Nha Trang Street Food Tour scooter. From back here, you can see why this is one of Vietnam's most popular beach destinations. 6 kilometers of white sand coastline, loads of laid-back atmosphere, and more than enough food places to fill up our 7 hours on land. Our first street eat spot is a hole in the wall that we probably wouldn't have noticed if it weren't for Tao and our tour guides. The specialty here is this petite thing called bankan.
These are mini pancakes. Tapos what they do is they put a quail egg. They break a quail egg and then they put squid, also different kinds of topping, I suppose. There's a guy here, he's eating siguro mga 12 pancakes.
I've got a feeling about this bankan.
Tao is the guy responsible in forming this whole street food tour in a scooter. Yeah. And you know what? It is so interesting. You know why?
Super.
you know, the dishes that we're gonna try, we've never tried or we've never encountered before. Have you seen anything like this?
No, never.
Diba?
We bring you to the place that only local people know.
Yes.
So this one we call it Banh Can. The specialty that you see the pot is very small one.
Yeah.
And it's made from ceramic.
Yeah, made from ceramic.
Oh. And that kind of ceramic, they good. It's made by Champa people. Mm-hmm. It's about 150 kilometers to the south.
Like all the popular dishes in Vietnam, there's a particular way to enjoy the street food here in Nha Trang.
You need fried spring onion, you need this fish sauce here.
And my favorite ingredient?
Is, you know what it is?
Green mango.
Yeah!
Tao says you can add chili if you like, and even chicharron for fun.
How to eat it?
Okay.
You hold one.
Dip.
Give it in, turning around.
Yeah.
How with some spring onion and some mango together.
Yeah.
But don't hold it inside too long, otherwise it becomes too salty.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, just it enough, and then I'll eat.
Okay.
Dapat one bite, diba?
Oh my God. This is so good.
Oh my God.
Imagine this, huh? Now, the green mango sour, salty from the fish sauce, and then it's spicy. And then you have bursts of different flavors. Oh my God, so good.
So good.
I like how the bottom's crunchy.
Yeah. And then you put top it with chicharron.
This is not just Vietnamese street food. Banh Can is an authentic Nha Trang specialty, and I can't get enough of it.
Oh no, this is Tao street food.
Not wrong. Guys, if you come here, you have to look for Tao.
Galing. Totally new experience. This is real street food. You're discovering new street food that you've never experienced before. Magugulat kayo dito sa taste dito. Huh?
Yeah.
Boom!
Boom, really. What?
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, hi. No, actually, ang ganda nga eh. What an interesting way to go around the city, di ba?
Yeah.
Beautiful scenery. Did you see the street food? Yung mga different...
Yeah.
I just wonder what kind of food you'll be serving there, no? Maraming street food, you know?
You can see some of the people driving the motorcycles. They're like wearing heels.
Oh.
But Nha Trang is so much more than just a resort destination. It also offers an eye-popping trip down southern Vietnam's memory lane. Our tour guides bring us to the two most famous historical sites in the city. The Ponagar Cham Tower is a sacred Hindu site that was built way back in the 7th century to honor the mother of the Cham Kingdom. Remember the Banh Can that we had earlier today? This is another legacy of the same Cham civilization.
It's a matriarchal society. So this is the queen, this is the, what is this?
Sivar, the king.
The king.
King, the son.
Okay.
The other famous landmark in town is the Buddhist Long Son Pagoda. Built in 1886, it is one of the largest and oldest pagodas in Nha Trang. Architecture lovers will find this and the long climb up to the Buddha statue quite breathtaking.
So what the tour guide was telling us is that in history, there's this monk that in protest, he set himself on fire. And apparently that monk, this is his hometown, or this was the temple where he grew up in. And if you guys Google it, it's super cool. You can't find the image. If you Google the album of Rage Against the Machine, you'll see that picture of that monk that set himself on fire. Super cool. And apparently his heart's still alive. When he died and everything was burnt, his heart was still beating.
This is only the beginning. When we return, Tao shows us more of Nha Trang's wonders and of course, more street food that only locals know.
Parang spring roll. And as you dip it in the liquid, it becomes soft, yung rice wrapper.
Keep it here on FoodPrints. We'll be right back. there's so much more to discover in Vietnam than just Ho Chi Minh City. Today, my kids and I are digging into the unique flavors of Nha Trang, a seaside city in southern Vietnam. The pace of life here is very relaxed and easygoing. Even their favorite mode of transportation.
Nakakatuwa. Nakakatuwa. You know, I've never been here before in this place. And you know what he did? Si Tao brought me through the local area. Halos walang tourists. So, it's really interesting. So, you know, I really recommend people who have never been to this area before to come visit. Because, can you imagine, it's a $39 tour in a scooter. You visit two temples, and then there are four different kinds of street food that you will experience for that price. Isn't that a bargain? Tingnan natin kung ano ba pakain niya.
I'm so happy to be experiencing all these wonders with my kids for the first time, especially when it's time to try another local delicacy. Unlike the tiny banh can, the banh show is large.
So it's butter, they have squid, they put shrimp, they put pork, and then they put a batter nga, that batter which is a pancake, and then they put spring onions and bean sprouts, plenty of bean sprouts, then they cover it. Now this is what it comes out to. And then there are two ways of eating it. You can either get some sauce, pati sauce, which is a little bit sweet also, and then you can dip that here, fold it and dip it here, and have some vegetables. I was watching a lady there, how she ate it. Or you can have a wrapper, rice paper wrapper. Okay, so this I have cut. Tao taught me how to wrap. Yeah, parang spring roll. Yeah. I'm gonna get some chili. Look at that. And as you dip it in the liquid, it becomes soft, yung rice wrapper.
So you're type up.
Oh my! This is bursting with flavor. You have to try this.
First thing that jumps out is the saltiness and the sweetness of the fish sauce. Then comes out the freshness of the greens. And then the crunch of the pancake. It is so good.
I am the undertones.
So how does it compare to banh can?
Iba naman yun eh. Well, it's close because both are pancakes. But this one is a bigger version. The sauce is the same, more or less. But the other one had the sourness of the mango. But this one is also very good and unique also. Wow.
I think this is my favorite so far.
Really?
Yeah.
This will be such a
so far.
You know what? I haven't had a single disappointing bite in Nha Trang so far. All the places we went to are spot on. Excellent job by the Nha Trang Street Food Tour Team.
Alam mo, magaling ito si Tao. Magaling si Tao mamili.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't bring it to yung mga typical tourist places. These are totally unique experiences.
Yeah. Cheers. Cheers, guys. Sarap.
Yay!
This is not only good, it's outstanding.
We're down to our last hour in this lovely island city, and we still have two things to accomplish. So the kids and I decide to split up. They're heading down to the last street food stop of the day, while my last assignment is to find the one thing we absolutely must take home from Nha Trang.
Oh, thank you. You know what? In those two places that we visited, yung mini pancake and the big pancake, the one that really bound everything together was the patis or the fish sauce. So, Tao is giving me a box of fish sauce. This is a gift. Thank you very much, Tao.
You're welcome. It's a fish sauce from Vietnam, from
okay.
Nha Trang.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Thank you so much.
Take it from me, guys. If there's only one culinary treasure you should look for in Nha Trang, it is their humble fish sauce.
All right, guys. So my dad is right now he's buying patis. He can't get enough of it. And so for our whole day of street food, this is our last stop. And what a perfect way to end with some soup, with some noodles. They would come to me.
I'm sorry to have missed this last tour stop because I hear that this noodle dish called banh bo is Tao's number one choice when it comes to street food.
I think we have some beef noodles, spring onions, and some blood.
It reminds me of the pho. The broth is very similar. Mm. It has the spices.
Yeah. But I don't know. There's something different about it.
I think it's the lemongrass.
Yeah.
Man, this dish is very consistent with all the other dishes of Vietnam. Very
healthy
and refreshing. And it's not just healthy because you know what the ingredients are. It tastes very healthy as well, which is very nice. You know, if you were to go on a food tour and try different dishes throughout the day, I think Vietnamese food would be perfect because it's light.
At first, I wouldn't think Vietnam, but after trying all this food,
I totally agree.
Guys, there's so many options for that Vietnamese food.
I'm surprised by all the ways they were able to use every ingredient, like from the boiled eggs kanina to the pancake. A symphony of flavors.
Oh, look at my kids taking up the reins of the family business. Proud dad right here. On the other side of the break, we're back on the majestic superstar Virgo to try and pack more memories before the cruise comes to an end. My second cooking demo on board is up next.
I'm going to cook a shepherd's pie and we have Spanish callos.
We're back cruising the high seas, and this time, the ship is bringing us back home to Manila. Fortunately, it takes more than a day to bring us back home, which means we have lots of time to max out the fun on board the Superstar Virgo.
You know, this morning we have a cooking demonstration, and all of this is going to be successful. You know why? I have help. I have help from mga kababayan natin. I'm going to cook, initially I'll make a shepherd's pie, and then we have Spanish callos.
Now, shepherd's pie might sound intimidating to make, but just like my first cooking demo, today's dishes are confidence-building recipes that are easy to make yet give impressive results.
Okay, so umpisa natin to, bawang.
Saute garlic and onions, add some chopped red and green bell peppers, then add the meats.
So I'm cooking the ground beef. I add the ground pork. And what I want to do here is just to change the color. Mawala lang yung pinkish color ng ating ground meats. There are some parts that are going to stick on the pan. So what you want to do is you want to deglaze the pan. Yung deglazing is picking up the flavors. May lasa yan. So lalagyan natin ng tubig.
Make sure that the ground meats don't clump together. Now, it's time to add the rest of the ingredients.
Ito, beef powder. Tomato ketchup. But if we're making an Asian version of this, and then you use hoisin sauce, banana ketchup, sesame oil, yung mga ganyan. No? This one is barbecue sauce. You know, what will happen here is the beef and the pork will sweat. Okay? Tapos seasoning sauce. Both meats will sweat and the mixture will become a little bit watery. Me, I like to have my shepherd's pie dry toasted. So, tagalan ninyo pag-gisa.
While that's drying out, let me show you the perfect complement to our next mixture.
I make my mashed potatoes. I mash it with a fork. Gusto ko yung may konting lumps eh. Alam mo kung bakit? Kasi gusto ko dun sa mga kumakain, hindi instant mashed potato ito. Di ba? Kasi yung iba, instant eh. No? So gusto ko may konting lumps. Minsan yung sinasama ko pa nga yung balat eh. Okay din yun. Tapos I just mix butter and cream. Mix it all together. Salted butter. Tapos konting salt. Konting asin pa. Or if you like to put pepper. Okay na yan. Ito na yung mashed potatoes natin.
Transfer the mashed potatoes to a piping bag before transferring the dry toasted meats to a baking dish.
You know, at this point, if you stop, you can serve this as arroz a la cubana. You just fry some saba bananas and fried eggs. You put it on top. Arroz a la cubana na yan, no? Okay, ito na. So, piping na tayo. Can you imagine yung taste na nito? Na-imagine nyo yung nata, di ba? At this point,
you can top it with cheese, no? Some people, what they do is they put ketchup. Ito, cheddar cheese lang ito. Usually, I don't put mga Swiss cheese, yung mga Emmental or Gruyere, kasi yung medyo bland ng konti yun eh. If you wanna put that, it's nice because of the texture, kasi medyo gooey siya yung mahaba. Pero lagyan mo ng cheddar para mas may sharp yung, di ba ma'am? Sharp yung taste. Okay, and then this one, we're just going to bake to put a little color to it, and that's it.
See, it's so easy. Like I said, there are easy recipes that I hope will inspire you to cook more at home. Ready for another confidence-building recipe? Let's make some authentic
Spanish callos.
It all starts with beef tripes. These have already been cleaned by simmering them in a vinegar and water mixture for about 20 minutes. Then tenderized by simmering again in chicken stock for another 3 hours. Next, we start cooking by rendering some good old bacon. Yum!
If you look at the ingredients, you cannot come up with a dish that's good. Eh. Lagay natin yung chorizo muna so that we get some color. Ito chorizo de Bilbao, you can buy it sa Manila, nakakant na eh. Tapos onions, lagay natin yung onions natin. Lagay natin itong ating tomatoes. Carrots, lagay natin. Red bell peppers. Green bell peppers. Ako, alam nyo, iniiba-iba ko lang yung mga cuts ng mga peppers para may variety lang. But you see, yung mga flavors nag-a-add din dyan. So we have pimiento.
Add half a cup of cheap white wine, then dump in your tenderized beef tripes.
Wow, lakit nito. Look at that. Now, what I want to do here is just to simmer this hanggang maging concentrate at lumabas yung lakit. You have any questions? Gutom na kayo. Huwag na kayo mag-lunch. Dito na kayo mag-lunch. Mas mura rito. Libre, libre rito.
You'll know it's done when the sauce reduces and is finally thick and sticky. Season with salt and pepper if needed, then serve proudly with toasted bread. Boom! It's tasting time!
Better than callos in No downgrading, but I like it better than
Oh, thank you very much. Alam nyo, some people say they like it better than other places, but the key talaga, you simmer it para lumabas yung taba, yung gelatin.
But, yeah, it's even
yung sticky?
Yes.
Yan ang pinaka-importante. That's the characteristic you have to look for in callos, yung sticky.
Identifies perfectly.
Ah, thank you. I hope you enjoyed the recipes. And based on some comments that I've heard, it's better than other restaurants they've tried. Nakakataba ng puso yun. So I hope I was able to achieve
yes,
that.
Sir.
Share something that you in turn can cook for your loved one. But you know what? Bottom line, I had fun. I really had fun. Mamayang gabi, bingo!
It's our last night on board the ship and there's still time to packet some last minute experiences. Walang tulugan ito, my foodie friends. See you when FoodPrints return.
We'll see you again in our next trip.
Bye.
Have a few hours to make the most out of this luxury experience. Fortunately, the last night on board the ship is usually reserved for cocktails and a gala dinner where the guests meet the ship's crew.
That's the captain right there. We're having cocktails, some festivities with everyone. Medyo, if you notice, medyo naka-formal altar yung mga karamihan ng tao.
It's nice to see how many or how few we're responsible for keeping us safe, fed, and entertained for the last 5 days. Bravo to the crew of the Superstar Virgo for a fantastic cruise experience.
Captain's here, all his crew's here. Saan kaya nagda-drive nung cruise? Ako kaya, puntahan ko kaya ako mag-drive doon. Wala sila nandito eh.
Here's a tip. Don't forget to bring at least one set of smart casual clothes in your luggage. You don't want to be underdressed for the fancy gala dinner.
Well, the menu is, they have seafood, beef, yung beef medallion. The other one is lobsters and the other one is vegetarian.
I'm getting the baked Boston lobster.
So what are you having, Kurt?
I'm having the beef medallion tower.
I've got to say, it is really impossible to go hungry here. Feeding you is like top priority on this ship.
For a cruise, being in the sea for about 5 or 6 days, you know, the quality that they're serving isn't bad at all. Yeah.
Ako, I like their simple lunches, like, let's say fried chicken lang, no? Parang very
ko.
But I like the fried chicken. Tapos, yeah, you know what they make well? They make very good fried rice.
Here, very, very good.
Diba? Yeah. Breakfast also, I enjoy their breakfast. Kanina was, ano, French toast.
Yeah, really good.
You like that, no? And I like their bacon. It's lean.
They may not be the most life-changing meals you'll ever have, but you have to applaud the galley crew for taking care of the 600-odd guests aboard every time. It's an impossible job, and yet, they get it done efficiently.
Yeah, the salmon's pretty good.
What kind of sauce are you using? Is that? Cream sauce. Cream sauce. How is that?
There's this green sauce here. Not sure what that is. But I'll have it with some of the mushroom.
What is it? Is it pesto sauce?
It's
parang,
really
parang spinach.
Yeah.
Spinach or broccoli sauce.
It's good, it's good though.
How about you, Danielle? How is yours?
It's pretty good. It's because the sauce is tomato. There's like bell pepper, olives, and tomatoes as a garnish over the
meal.
Which I like.
A tenderloin steak.
The sauce is very nice. To me, a bit overcooked, but I can understand because when you do volume cooking like this, it's hard to control the temperature. So this was cooked maybe an hour before dinner was served. So it's been sitting and kept warm, it's going to be overcooked. You're cooking for about, what, 600, 800 people?
Yeah.
You cannot control the doneness of the beef. So you just have to rely on the tenderness, which it is. Actually, it's actually medium. Diba? It's not so bad, actually. And you cannot ask everybody how they like it done because it's going to be too complicated. Diba? But it's pretty good. Very good, actually, with the mushrooms. Nice.
Dinner is over. Everyone is satisfied. And the night is still young. What do people do on a ship after hours, you may ask?
Our bingo board consists of three items.
You know, this is going to be our last night here in the cruise.
Yeah.
And we're going to leave this place with a bang.
Or should I say, bing. This turned out to be the Daza family's nightly gimmick on the superstar Virgo. Bingo at the Galaxy of Stars.
This is a different kind of bingo. This is not the one where you have lines and mga cross and all that. She will announce, she'll press a button, it will pop up a number, and then you just mark it, or you poke a hole, or mark it. Okay? And then if you get 15 before she reaches 40 numbers, you hit the jackpot.
69 Hong Kong dollars for one set of cards is not cheap. Consider that the jackpot is 120,000 Hong Kong dollars. Pwede na, di ba? Uy, wait! It looks like Danielle won!
89!
Yes, we have!
90!
Yeah.
Well, she wasn't able to win the entire jackpot prize, but she took home just enough to buy us another round of drinks for tonight.
Wow, what a way to end this episode, no?
Woo!
You guys have fun?
Danielle.
Danielle, wow! Unbelievable! You know,
Danielle!
You know what they were saying? That because I'm a chef daw, niluto ko daw. Kaya you guys too.
Galing.
Anyway. So,
great trip.
So what was it? What did you enjoy the most?
For me, the scooter tour ride.
The scooter tour ride. And I think just spending time with each other was pretty cool. It was different.
Unbelievable.
So good.
So good.
I just, you know.
Puro yung discovering something unexpected we've never tried
before. The food, Vietnamese food.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
So healthy, and healthy, so delicious.
The most delicious part of it all, it's making unique memories with my top four favorite people in the world.
We'll see you again in our next trip.
Yep.
Bye.
See you guys. Thanks for joining us.